What was so fascinating about this setting, not besides the physical space on the campus, was the ability to work with these children, these refractory kids with psychiatric issues over a long period of time, something that is quite unique in our field and quite rare, should I say. Kids stay here for a period of time, could be from 3 to 4 months, and I run an inpatient unit, essentially, of about 12 to 13 adolescent kids.
Our emphasis is on depth and wholesomeness of our assessments and in our treatments. So we take our time.
We undertook this project of minimizing and actually reducing almost to zero our restraint and seclusion rates. And that became actually a global model, which was born out of this facility.
Our role in the system is to take a step back, evaluate all of this, synthesize it, and come up with some new meaningful and engaging plan that can mobilize the family, the community resources, and create a roadmap for something that hopefully this time is going to make a difference.
This is the best place from the professional perspective. This particular facility has affiliation with Yale, so you could have always growth in your profession and learning curve. And it's very satisfying when it comes to the providing the care, and the location is amazing.
We're fortunate to be in a very progressive state of Connecticut. You know, we have some of the best mental health services. We have the opportunity in a small state to be very connected to our population.
One needs to be excited about the advocacy piece of it, be motivated to trying to make changes in the system as part of the system.
For somebody who's really interested in inpatient psychiatry, I think this would be a great island in an ocean of underserved. I cannot compare it with any other place that I've had the opportunity to work or have heard about, where you have such a clinically rich resource team that makes your job easy.